It even spins. Look at that. It's like a little helicopter scissors there.
The great thing about ribbon cutting is the more people, the better.
As many staff as can fit behind the guys, let's go ahead and start filing in.
You can help me if you want. I mean, you can even do it.
Yeah, if I
can't get a little more to understand.
You can stick with that. It's all good.
That's okay.
That's great.
Yes, I am.
He's tall enough to see all the money.
So now we gotta fake it first, though, so everybody can get the picture they want.
Yeah, I know. Get out of your way.
So we won't actually cut anything yet.
No,
in fairness,
I'll give you a countdown.
Why don't we all look this way first so we don't look like crazy people with eyes going? So we'll all look at the woman in the black and white dress. All right, the woman with the white phone. Straight ahead at the guy with the real camera. All right, over to the woman in the salmon colored sweat. All right, over here to the right guy in the tan suit. A couple times. All right. Awesome. All righty.
All right, on the count of three. One, two, three.
All right. Y'all can hear me just fine. Thank you for coming. I mean, what an extraordinary day. You really couldn't ask for a better day for something like this. It's exciting. Anytime you can cut a ribbon is enjoyable, but when it's involving the resuscitation of something so historic, not only for an industry that is really hitting all new time highs, but also just for this community and for this city itself. A lot of you probably know, but Colonel Edmund Taylor, after whom the original plant was named, used to be the mayor of Frankfort, actually, and was as involved as anybody in really modernizing the bourbon industry. And so to have seen this over the course of about 80 years, start 60, 70, 80 years, 90 years almost before it was shut down in the early 70s, to have taken on such incredible proportions and to be so beautiful in this regard, but then to be shut down, to have it fall into such a state of dilapidated condition, and then to sit vacant, which nothing that sits vacant for 40 years tends to do well, is rarely ever brought back to life. And for Will and Wes and Marianne to look at this, to have the passion and the vision for this, and to be able to just be dedicated, speaks volumes about not only their willingness to give back to this community, but also just their confidence that they could make it work. And this is remarkable, it really is. What an incredible, incredible place. So thank you for being here to celebrate with this team. They're the ones we really want to hear from. Congratulations to each of you. Will and I went to school together 30 plus years ago. Nobody, I can just tell you right now, I'll speak for myself, but I'm gonna also speak for, nobody would have bet either one of us would have been standing here in this capacity. to say that's probably a fairly safe statement. That said, it's amazing how life goes. The American dream is a real and powerful thing. Congratulations, Pete.
Thank you very much.
A small mint julep cup that I'm going to ask you, you can do whatever you want with it, but how awesome would it be if the very first toast you ever raise in that is a mint julep, perhaps, with some of your very own product. So how long that sits on your shelf before you feel the urge to toast with something else, I'll leave up to you, but congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Everyone to Woodford County. Don called me yesterday and said the governor's coming for the grand opening, and John, you won't have any responsibility. And then as soon as I got here, they asked me to say a few words. So thank you very much, Don. It's important today for Woodford County. I know, I think their mailing address is Frankfort, but they are in Woodford County. They have turned this place from an eyesore to a gem. Actually a show place. I met these guys from the very start, Will West at the very end. They have done a wonderful job. I'm so proud of them. I support what they have done down here and what they're doing. Supported them in all their projects. We are so glad. This is what can happen when two or three folks get together with a vision, with determination and dedication, and a little bit of money and a lot of love. Some of it good, some of it bad, but we wish them well, and I'm so proud that they have turned this eyesore into a show place. Thank you very much.
Standing here at the front doors of something that opened up, you know, over 100 years ago. And, you know, I remember, you know, a little over 5 years ago sitting in a Mexican restaurant with Will in Lexington, and he showed me a real estate brochure of this property he had found, and I thought he was pretty crazy. And then I agreed to visit. down here on a Saturday afternoon, and I joined him in the craziness. It was a pretty easy decision at that point. When you walked around, even though this place was literally covered in all kinds of brush and trees and debris and there's environmental issues, every potential reason to say no existed. The no is the easy part, the yes was the hard. And 4.5 years later, to be here, to be at a point where we were able to take something that I think pretty much everybody didn't think we could accomplish and do it, is a really amazing feeling. And it, we didn't do it, really. All of us did it. Everybody here was part of that process. And it's so exciting to see all the new faces who come on board, who sort of gravitate towards the passion this place evokes in people, because they see what it was and now what it's becoming again. So thank you all, every last one of you. We wouldn't be here today. You all played a role, everybody on this side and especially everybody behind us. So thank you all very, very much. And I'll turn it over to
this is a huge day for us, and we're just so fortunate to have so many friends and family and co-workers who are our friends and family to join us here today to officially open the site to the world. You know, it's been a long time that we've been a little bit greedy and kept it to ourselves, but we're excited to let people in and share all the progress that we've made, like Wes and Will have shared. It's not been easy, and it's not been a short process, but I think what we've accomplished in the past four and a half years has been pretty incredible, you know, when we look back on it. So thank you all for coming, and let's do it.
That concludes the ribbon cutting, but they just informed me that they're going to let you walk through the facility.